Hello, I'm Greg Nichols, the Science and Technology Advisor for the Homeland Defense and Security Information Analysis Center. And today we're going to talk about small modular reactors, or SMRs. An SMR is a type of nuclear reactor that has a very compact design, and they actually are used to generate electricity in the range of 300 megawatts or less. And that's a lot smaller than what we see at a nuclear power plant, where the reactors generate about 1,000 megawatts of electricity or more. So compact reactor designs, such as a SMR, actually have several advantages. So first of all, because of their compact design, they're a lot smaller, so they have less features to worry about, so they actually have improved safety features. They also often have a passive system, so they don't require human interaction to shut down or be maintained. Another thing that actually makes an SMR really good to use is that they can use spent fuel from other reactors. So the uranium and plutonium that is used in other reactors wears down over time, but that fuel can actually be reprocessed and used in an SMR. So you actually have less waste to worry about in terms of storage and in terms of security. Another thing that SMRs are actually very good for is not only generating electricity, but also purifying water. So they can be used in a process called desalinization, where we could take salt water or seawater, remove the salt, and actually make fresh water. So that actually is a big benefit when you look at remote places that don't necessarily have access to fresh water. So in terms of military applications, an SMR would be a really good type of power to have, because it would allow a base to be relatively energy independent. So you wouldn't have a military base that would be reliant on a larger power grid. And in case there was an attack of some kind where the electrical system would go down, the SMR would still continue to function and provide power for the base. So thanks for tuning in today. You can find more information about SMRs on hdioc.org, and you can follow us on Twitter.